Well, we've heard many facts about the story of Jonah already. And today, I want to tell you just some facts. So fact number one, God asked Jonah to do something. Fact number two, Jonah didn't do it. Fact number three, Jonah got on a ship going far away from Nineveh. Fact number four, there is a big storm at sea. They tossed Jonah into the ocean. Fact number five, Jonah is sucked into a giant whale. Fact number six, Jonah prays. Good job, Jonah. Fact number seven, Jonah is spit out on a beach. Fact number eight, Jonah tells the people the message that God has for them. Fact number nine, people turn to God. Yay! And fact number 10, Jonah still has a bad attitude. Oh my, this story is so full of good news and bad news. Let's go see now what Jonah's up to. Hi, kids. So there's some good news today. Number one, God loves Jonah. But there's also some bad news. Jonah's bad attitude did not change. Oh, Jonah. So, if you have your Action Bible, turn to page 434. And right at the very bottom of the page, it says, once again, God tells Jonah to go to Nineveh. And this time, Jonah obeys. Good job, Jonah. Way to go. So Jonah went throughout the city of Nineveh for 3 days. And every day he called out to the people the very same message. Day one, in 40 days, God is going to destroy your city. Day two, in 40 days, God is going to destroy your city. Day three, what do you think he said? Say it with me.
In 40 days, God's going to destroy your city.
So look at page 435 at the very top of the page. And it says there, but to Jonah's shock and dismay, the people actually listened to him. To show how sorry they are, they put on black clothes, even the king. Well, boys and girls, the Bible says that the king stood up from his throne and he put on his black clothes because he called them his sad clothes. And the king put on his black clothes and he sat in the dust and he said sorry to God. And then he said to the people, you put on your black clothes, you sit in the dust and you tell God you're sorry too. Wow. So what does God do? God sees that the people of Nineveh have turned away from their sin, and true to his word, he does not destroy them after all. Thank you, Lord. You are a great and a good God. However, Jonah does not take God's change of heart very well. Jonah said, I should have known, even when people are scum and rotten and filthy and awful and bad, you show mercy, Lord. Just kill me. If this is the kind of work you want me to do, just let me die. Oh my goodness. Poor Jonah. He had such a bad attitude. But God continued to show his love to Jonah. He loved Jonah very much, and he loved all the people very much. And God loves you very much. God loves people no matter what. When people sin and turn away from God, well, God actually goes looking for them. And then he calls to them, and then he draws them. Because God's love for people is even bigger than we can understand. God's love for people is bigger than your mommy or your daddy's love for you. Do you know what it says in the Bible? In John, in 1 John 3:1, it says, "See what amazing love the Father has given us. Because of it, we are called children of God." And that's what we really are. So thank you, God, for your great love. Thank you that you love us now, and you're always going to love us. And God, we love you too. Let's say it all together. God, we love you. Let's say it again. God, we love you. One more time.
God, we love you.
Amen. Tonight I started out by saying, the good news is that God loved Jonah. Now the bad news was that Jonah had a bad attitude. It says in the Action Bible, after he told the people of Nineveh that God was going to destroy their city, he headed out east to a place where he could sit and watch what God would do to the city. And so he hid under a tree that had some branches for shade, and he waited there. And then the tree died, and he had no shade, and the wind began to blow, and it was super hot. And then God gave him a plant, well, maybe with great big leaves like this, to cover his head, to protect him from the sun. But then the next day, God sent a big worm who ate the plant. And so Jonah had terrible troubles there. And it says that on the bottom of page 435, it says that God scolded Jonah for his bad attitude. You see, God was teaching Jonah that he loves people. No matter what, God loves people. Jonah didn't love those bad people in Nineveh, but they changed. And God did not destroy them because he loves everybody. God was teaching Jonah to love people too. Well, thank you, God. Thank you that you love everybody, no matter what. And God, we love you. Say it with me again.
We love you.
Hi, kids, and welcome to Tricky Bits. Our Tricky Bits question tonight is from Annabella Kay, and she's a grade 2 student, and she said, how is it possible to be swallowed by a fish and not die? Well, that's a great question. Thank you for it, Annabella. And you know, some people think that that could never happen, but Jesus believed it because he talked about it in Matthew 12 and verse 40. He quotes that scripture that Jonah was in the fish for 3 days and three nights. So if Jesus believed it, I believe it too. So the word that they use in the Bible for a big fish was actually sea monster. Wow, the fish was called a sea monster. That's scary. Well, the Bible also says that the Lord prepared a great fish. That was Jonah 1:17. So, God prepared a special fish. You know, this is a story about miracles. First, there's a sea monster, and then it eats a man, and then the man lives. Well, there's three miracles right there. And when it comes right down to it, our God is all powerful. He's the creator of everything. He prepared a fish or a sea monster. He had the perfect timing. He kept the man alive. He can do anything. He can do everything. God is not limited. He can do anything. We serve a mighty and an awesome God. So tonight, before we finish, let's sing that song together. Our God is an awesome God.
Our God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven.